Hello internets, hope you're doing fine. I am back with another episode on trying to make 3D run smooth in Godot 3. And in this one, I want to focus on fixing camera jitter because I was getting quite a bit of that, which was especially noticeable on my 240Hz display with physics FPS hard set to 60. So I started Googling and I found that whenever someone asks this question somewhere, they'd get the same set of suggestions. So I tried them all out and I found one that actually works very well. So let me tell you what about it. The first technique I tried, and probably the most obvious, was to move the camera script from physics process into process, which runs faster, usually as fast as your resources allow it to. For me, the difference was significant because this game normally usually runs at about 200 frames or more. On my PC, and there's a huge discrepancy between, you know, physics FPS, which is set to 60 by default, and the actual FPS that I'm getting from the engine, hence the jitter. At first, I just moved the camera rotation to process, and initially it looked pretty sweet, but once I got into a fight, problems appeared. I saw this onion skin movement of the enemies, which were moving in physics process while the camera was updating the visuals twice or three times as fast, and it created this horrible jerky onion skin effect. You can clearly see that on the player as well. My camera is a child of the player node, and it's moving with the player, so I had to also move the player movement script into process as well. And this helped a little bit, but far from fixed it. I'd have to move all of my movement code to process for everything that is doing any kind of movement in the entire game, which is a bad idea on so many levels. I mean, it's strongly recommended that you keep your player movements in physics process so that it's in lockstep with NPCs in world physics. Otherwise, you're out of sync and you're completely vulnerable to the whims of your process delta, which fluctuates a lot depending on your PC and depending on what's going on in the game and so on and so forth, and you're basically losing stability and consistency, and that is all pretty bad. So it became obvious that I should probably abandon this technique altogether, which I did. The second technique I tried was upping the physics FPS in settings. I experimented with different values and discovered that the best result is when I divide my refresh rate by 2. So I set the physics FPS to 120. And the outcome was just perfect. It's smooth like silk. One other perk of this approach is that your physics is actually more accurate when it updates more frequently, which is logical, right? Collisions, movement and so on, they're all more precise and fluid. Until your engine FPS drops below your physics FPS setting, that is. I wondered what would happen if that occurred, so I loaded the scene up with a stupid number of attacking enemies just to force performance to drop, and when the game dropped under 60 frames, with physics trying to execute its state 120 times every second, things got exponentially worse. It was just completely unplayable. Effective FPS was like literally 11, so I needed to try something else. I mean, you could set your physics FPS in code to say go back to 60 if engine FPS is lower than 120, and I did try that and it kind of worked, but the pace was inconsistent. So the whole game would slow down and then speed up, and then it would slow down and speed up again. It was really noticeable and annoying, and you don't want that in an action game. So I let it go and moved on to option 3, which was timestep interpolation. There is a method in the engine class called getPhysicsInterpolationFraction, which allows you to do physics interpolation. Godot doesn't do physics interpolation out of the box, to my knowledge, but you can still do it by fractioning the interval between physics frames. If your physics simulation is set to the default 60 physics FPS, then physics updates 60 times per second regardless of what the engine frame rate is. So if the engine runs your game at, let's say, 180 FPS, then 180 divided by 60 is 3. So for each physics frame, you actually get 3 additional frames which you could use to interpolate the movement. And you can do it with a plugin, or you can just use a script like I did. What you need to do first though is separate the camera from the node that does the moving and rotating. I have it set up like this. I have a camera root node that moves and slides back, forth and sideways. Then I have a 3D node as its child that does the horizontal rotation based on mouse motion on the x-axis, and then a grandchild 3D node that does the vertical rotation on the y-axis. So previously my camera was a child of the V node, so I just replaced that with another 3D node which I called the camera mount, and this now does the rotations, but the real camera is on a separate branch. Now, it doesn't need to be on a separate branch because we'd be detaching it in the code anyway, but the tree just looks a bit cleaner this way. So attach this script to your actual camera, or you can parent the camera to a 3D node like I did and attach the script to that 3D node. Both ways should work. And what this simple script does is it takes the transform of the camera mount node, so the node that used to be the camera, and copies it onto the actual camera. But it does it in process using the timestep fraction, which is why it's so smooth. Okay, so take a look. We have this target variable to which you need to assign your camera mount as a target. This will be the source of our transform data. We set our new camera as top level, so it doesn't inherit its parent's transforms. That's why I said before, it really does not matter where in the scene you put your smooth camera. Then we declare two transforms, previous and current, and we update them on every frame. So current goes to previous and the new current goes to current. And then we fraction the physics frame, and we use that fraction to interpolate the previous transform with the current transform. That's all there is to it. And I did that to the camera and also did that to the player mesh, and I am really pleased as punch with the result. It just plays so incredibly smooth now. I hope you can see it. And it's a very simple script too, so what's not to love? Anyway, I hope this was helpful in some way. If so, please give it a like, hit subscribe if you're enjoying this kind of content, and I will see you in the next video. Peace.